Joseph Alain, Chevalier de Saint-George, was born in Belle Isle, Guadeloupe in 1745 and died in Paris in 1799. He was not only a composer, violin virtuoso, and conductor, but also excelled as a fencer and athlete. His eventful life has inspired the imagination of biographers since the 19th century. He was the illegitimate son of an enslaved woman of Senegalese origin named Manon and Georges de Boulogne Saint-George, an important French plantation owner. Joseph gave signs of his precious gift at a very early age, knowing that in the colonies, his remarkable son would be condemned to a life of humiliation and casual cruelty. His father opted to bring him to France, where he would have greater opportunities and suffer less overt prejudice. George's decision to give his son the best possible education was vindicated early on by his spectacular achievements, and George must have taken immense pride in this. Of one thing we could be quite certain, if George had not shown a genuine interest in his son's welfare, then he would not be the Joseph Boulogne de Saint-George that is known today. Joseph's musical career was launched in the late 1760s. In 1769, he joined the Concerte des Amateurs as the violin's first leader. It was under his 8-year leadership that Parisian audiences heard Haydn symphonies for the first time. The concerts were open to subscription and largely featured new music, in particular symphonies, concertos, and symphony concerti. St. George's made his public debut as a violin soloist at the Concert des Amateurs in 1772, performing his two violin concertos, Opus 2. According to the Mercure de France, the works received the most rapturous applause, both for its excellent execution and for the composition itself. In addition to violin concertos, Joseph also composed operas and symphonies. Most recently, his life and remarkable accomplishments were depicted in the film Chevalier, premiered in theaters in April 2023.
Welcome to Paris, Joseph.
Monsieur, I fear this will not be a kind place to such a boy.
Boy has talent, but one in particular that is exceptional.
Very well.
I realized the more I excelled, the less I was alone.
You're always so competitive.
The show-off who spoiled Mozart's concert.
May I play with you, monsieur?
Well, I hope this won't be embarrassing for you. Who the hell is that?
You are quite a remarkable man,
Joseph.
I, Marie Antoinette, Queen of France, hereby anoint you Chevalier.
In any other country, a man of your color would not be wearing such fine clothes.
One day, the whole world will know me. And of course, the music will be spectacular. Bold.
You don't belong here. You're a party trick. Repet, playing the violin, that is all.
You know I am the best.
You are playing a dangerous game, friend.
You forget your place, boy.
Break his hands.
This world is painful for us, my son, but there is always the choice to fight.
I'm putting on a concert. Let us fund the revolution.
We cannot afford to make any more enemies.
France is changing.
You could be more influential than you know. Leverage it.
You will be erased. There will be no new France. You cannot topple what has been ordained by God.
Not everything is about you people.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
First of all, thank you so much for being such a wonderful audience. As much as it is fun for us to play, it's even more fun when we have a supportive audience, so we really appreciate that. It is spring semester, and that means we are celebrating our seniors. So this year we have six seniors that spent with us 4 years. So orchestra class is a very unique class in a way that in other classes students are maybe just for one semester, but in orchestra class students are with us for 4 years and they become really part of our family. When they come on stage, I would really like that you notice how only one of them is actually a music major. And if you wonder what is the value of liberal arts education, this is on display. You will see students are studying biology or physics or other subjects, but at the same time they have opportunity to grow as musicians. And that opportunity is not available at other types of universities, just at the liberal arts universities. So just bear with us for the next 5 minutes while we are celebrating our seniors. So lovely seniors, if you don't mind putting your instruments down and coming forward, that will be Anna, Audrey, Lindsay, Caitlin, Sierra, and Christina. So if you can just line up here. Her future plans are she will take a year off to gain experience and try new things before possibly going to graduate school. She has already secured an internship with the Asian American College Ministry called EPIC Movement, which she will begin the process of transitioning into during the month of May. And Anna secretly hopes to be again with us next year, and we really hope that she will be And next we have Audrey, who plays cello. I remember Audrey when she came for her entrance exams and audition all the way from Las Vegas, and I was very curious that she would make journey all the way to Northwest to study with us. She's getting Bachelor of Science in Psychology with a minor in Communication Sciences and Disorders. Her future plans are, her next step in life will be staying here at Pacific, she likes it very much, to pursue Master of Science degree in Speech Language Pathology at Pacific Speech Pathology Graduate Program. Please greet our wonderful audience. Next is Lindsay, she's already at the end of this road, and she plays French horn. She's getting a degree Bachelor of Science in Biology, and after graduation, Lindsay is planning to take a gap year to study for the MCAT before applying to medical school. We wish her all the best, as well to other students. Clarinet. She's getting Bachelor's of Science in Biology. Caitlin will be applying for an accelerated nursing school to get her Bachelor's in Nursing with the ultimate goal of getting Master's in Nursing to be a nurse practitioner. We wish you all the best as well to other students. Sierra Wolf, as you probably heard and saw, plays percussions.
She's getting a degree in physics with an environmental emphasis and a minor in philosophy. That's what liberal arts education will provide students with. Future plans, Sierra's next step after college is seeking an internship in environmental engineering. I wish you all the best as well to all other students. As you heard, that she's a music therapy major and she's still not sure of her future plans, so we cannot share that, but we are very curious to learn at some point. Oh, there are, okay. She's going on to internship and then get a job as a music therapist. Her cats will be included. Lovely. Thank you so much. Orchestra students, thank you musicians who joined us tonight, and thank you to lovely audience. We wish you all the best. Thank you.